Hello friends, this is Neeraj. Today I'm going to talk about a function which helps reduces the number of steps of data exploration in Python. We all know that as a part of visualization, we usually import pandas for data frame reading and matplotlib for the plotting purpose. And for the understanding of each and every variable of a data frame, we plot box plot and histogram for the numerical variables. And bar graph for the categorical variables. So this will be a time taking with the number of variables are more. So in order to automate the steps, we created a function such that data frame is passed to a variable, and list of indices are passed. Here indices are column numbers, and here the data frame is passed. So we created a condition when the passed data frames, let's say if 1 and 2 are passed, if the first one is a categorical variable, passed in the first cat is a categorical variable, it displays the bar graphs. If the second one is a numerical variable, it displays box plot and histogram. So if none indices are passed, we plot all the numerical plots for the variables, not the we omit the categorical one. So such conditions are made and for this function, and these graphs are not only displaying purpose, but also these graphs are saved to a path where given indices, whatever the indices are passed, those graphs are saved to this path, which will be helpful in the future. So this is how we automated the process by creating a function. This will be reducing lengthy steps with the variables are more.
Hi guys, I'm Sahir. As Neeraj discussed about the algorithm, I will be telling you the programming code involved behind that. So we are doing it in Python. The first necessary module is matplotlib, which is for plotting the graphs. The another is pandas, which is for dataset reading and manipulations. So we want to read dataset where it is. So I don't want to copy the path where it is, pasting it here. The another method is like opening a Windows Explorer and again locating my dataset. So I'm going to import a package for this, TKinter. It is a GUI which enables me for selecting of dataset in Windows Explorer. The next thing is I'm going to import ask directory function, which is for selection of a folder. This folder will be the location where my graphs are stored. Okay, next. The next step is creating an instance of TK. This is for creating the root window. So we are creating a root window in which there are two pop-ups. One will be for asking for the file name, another will be asking for the directory. So we are printing both and destroying the window. So let us see what happens. You can see that here behind there is a window. So we are selecting some data set. You can see behind here, it is selected .csv, cars.csv selected. This is a string. So let us select the location where we want to save the graphs. I'm selecting graphs. So you can see the both strings here, file name and directory. Now I'm going to read my CSV file based on that file name. As you can see, we have got top 5 elements. You can see categorical or 2 features and the remaining are numerical. So we want the distributions of that. Numerical has histogram and box plot, categorical bar graphs. So here you can see this is a sub function. This is our main function. So inside it, you can see this is our main function code. What happens if no argument is passed? So main condition is if no argument is passed, then it should be numerical. So first and foremost thing is we have to check if it is numerical. So I'm just iterating my whole data set, that is the data frame. The next thing in this line, I am checking it if the data type we are choosing is only numeric, which means not is equal to object. Not is equal to object means not category. Obviously, it should be numerical. Not category means numerical. So if it is not object and numerical, I am calling a function snhb. So the control of the program goes towards this function snhb. So again, again I am checking first observation of each column. So what it means? So here you can see the first observation. I am checking if the first observation of my data, if it is categorical or numerical. So basically, mostly first line of the data, it will be, we can judge if it is a categorical or numerical. So I am checking based on that. So my first line has some two categorical and remaining are numerical. So this numerical stuff will be iterated in this. So you can see it's a numerical. So next thing, we are setting sequence of the figure. So first I want to display histogram. So I'm telling plotting the histogram. So this is the first column, which is numeric. So in our case, it will be MPG. MPG will be plotting the histogram. Distribution of MPG, we are going to do that. And then the title of the graph, the Y label, which means the left side, the label, the X label of that. Here you can see, as I have specified some df dot. This is the dynamic taking of the column name, this one and this one. So dynamically, the column name gets, we can get the column name in labels. So the next thing after creating a graph is histogram is, I'm going to save it. So I will be saving it in my directory. Previously, I have mentioned the directory as directory is equal to some graphs folder. So that will be here. I am storing my file name as that path / histogram underscore. Again, this one will be dynamic feature name. So we have stored the histogram. And again in next, I want to plot box plot. So I'll be setting in sequence. I'll be calling this dot figure. Next thing is, I will be plotting the box plot for my feature, which will be, in our case, it will be first feature is MPG. MPG box plot will be done. So I am providing some title for that. As usually, I am giving it dynamic feature name for that graph. Similarly, the labels, and again, the file name is dynamic, which means the feature name will be my file name of graph. Saved graph. Finally, I am displaying all the graphs, what all I have plotted. So this is the numerical data. So what happens if it is not, no arguments are passed in it? It goes for the else condition. In the else condition, I am going to iterate the all of the features, whether I have to go for the categorical and as well as numerical. So I will be calling this function again, snhb. So in this case, no argument is passed means it must be numerical if no argument is passed. In the other case, it can be categorical as well as numerical. So we are iterating all the given features. So the control goes here. Again, the same thing happens. It will check for the numerical, again plotting the graphs, box plot, histogram, showing it. So what if the data feature is not a numerical? The control of the program goes here. It creates a bar graph for categorical. Similarly, here also dynamically we are storing the feature name into our graph's name. Let me execute this. So this is my main function. I am creating this whole thing as a module. This is my module. So this is a program the user creates. If you want to use my module, you need to import that. So traditionally what happens is, we are importing, we need to save this file as .py and then use Python script. Like this would be my file name, and directly using this for importing. So again, saving as Python script, it is a bit takes time. So I'm directly importing this import underscore ipnb. This enables me for importing directly a Python notebook. So I've directly imported the Python notebook as well as the file I've created.
Here I'm going to talk about how the function has been called. We need to import ipynb and graph.ty to call the, in order to take the CSV file from the path. If in case we get an error, we need to install pip install import ib in anaconda prompt. If we run this, the pop-up will be shown where CSV file need to be selected by the user. So here I'm selecting the cars data. So after running this, after selecting the CSV file, it will be asking for the destination folder where the plots need to be saved. So I'm selecting the plot where graphs need to be saved. So I'm selecting a folder here. I'm giving a new folder name for the graph. So you can see. I'm selecting the graph underscore 2 as a folder to save this graph. So after that, we need to import matplotlib and pandas. Then here the graph.dy.df is the variable name where the data frame has been passed, and 8, we are giving the indices as a 8, which means the 8 is the categorical variable. So the bar plot will be plot and it will be saved in the location which we have been specified. You can see here, this was the path where we selected the cars, and here's the path where we is given the destination path to save this graph. So when we run this, this graph will be saved in that location. Let's check it. So document graph underscore 2. So you can see this graph has been saved. So this is how we call the function. We can also give the df as a variable to pass the CSV file, and so this is how we call the function.